My name is Csongor. My email address is csongor@halmai.hu. The topic for today is the complexity matrix in PHP. In the beginning, I would like to tell you a short story about somebody who can be you. It is an artist who wants to pick up somebody, and the talk, the conversation starts with some geeky thing. Hey, baby, you know I am a dev. And the other party says that, oh, really? PhD dev? Wow, it sounds cool. Oh, yeah. And I work on a very complex program. Oh, really? How complex is it? Oh, my God, it is so much complex, you cannot even believe it. Oh, really? How much? It's hard to answer this question. Unfortunately, the slides are coming up from the screen, probably because I created on a different computer and different operating system, and sometimes it sucks. But the point is that quite similar conversation can happen between professional parties as well. For example, you, the developer, and your boss can have a similar conversation, which starts with discussing the code, which you, as a developer, you are asked to change somehow, but you say it's not too easy because it is too complex. And if your boss asks how complex it is, then you can say something, but not very precise things. And if your boss asks who made this huge mess of code, then you can say that, well, it was not me, it was somebody else. And the whole thing starts with pointing to somebody else, who the culprit was. And the boss asks who should be more careful next time, and what should be done in a different way, then you cannot really answer this thing. I mean, you can say that everybody else should be more careful next time, not me because I was doing well, but the others were making some mistakes. But the threshold when somebody has to change their behavior, it's very hard to define in this conversation. So for the question that how complex our software is, the answer is very hard. Quite similarly, if you are asked which is the biggest animal, then you cannot say, because an elephant is quite large and quite heavy, but a snake can be longer. So there are different dimensions what you can measure. This is a fisherman who can say that I caught such a big fish. And maybe it is such a big fish, maybe it is just such a small fish, but it depends on how you understand the answer. So what is a complexity metric? A complexity metric is a function, a mapping, which maps your source code into a number. One number which describes the complexity of the code in some way. For example, such a conversation is valid. Unfortunately, these letters should not be white. It is written here, how complex is the code? And the answer is 42, or whatever else. So the answer is always a number. Not necessarily a whole number, can be a fractional decimal number, but always a number, and always a non-negative number. So negative complexity doesn't exist. What kind of metrics can we talk about? So there are a lot, unfortunately. For example, a very simple and very frequently used complexity metric is the number of source code lines. It's very easy to understand, even if your grandmother, who doesn't write source code too frequently, can understand if you say that, hey, grandma, I wrote a 10-line long code, and the next day if you say that, hey, grandma, I wrote 100 lines today, then she can have some impression what amount of 100 line is. Another frequently used metric is a little bit tailored version of the previous one. If you eliminate the lines that are empty or the ones that contain only comments, then the remaining one is also kind of a metric. The benefit of this one compared to the previous one is that it protects against cheating. So, for example, if your boss says that I pay $1 for every line you produce, or $10 for every line you produce, then you will write a lot of empty lines, a lot of comments, and so on, and you will earn a lot. And then your boss can change the metric and use this one instead of that one. Another complexity metric which we use frequently is the file size. Because if you want to produce many, many lines, then you can create smart code formatting, which starts new lines after every plus symbol, or even more frequently, and the number of lines, the number of valid lines can be increased drastically, but the file size is a little bit more precise metric. I have seen a script once, the file size, sorry, the number of lines was 7, and the file size was 2 megabytes, because there was a very, very long line, and it contained a lot of important things. And there are many, many, many other metrics. We will see some later. More is better. This is not just about beer. It is about metrics as well, complexity metrics. If you apply only one complexity metric, then it can distort the impression how complex your code is. So for example, if you say you have only a one line of code, then you may assume that it's just a simple one, it shouldn't be so complex, but it can. One line, and it can be still very complex. If you have a short file, then it still can be much more complex than a long one. And there are many, many other contradicting aspects of different codes, which if you measure only one or two metrics, if you measure the complexity of the code with only one or two metrics, then it still seems to be complex, or it still, still seems to be simple. And if you apply more metrics, then you will have a much better understanding about the complexity. Okay. So why do we have to measure complexity? Because if you are developing a code, even if you are a one-man show and you are developing your own pet project, then if you measure the complexity of the code, then this regular report can tell you that, oops, this file is getting too complex, too long, too big, and it should be refactored. So this is an alert when we already made the mistake and the file became too complex. It tells in advance as well if we haven't reached the threshold which we already defined, what counts to be more too complex, then before reaching this point, we already can be alerted. If the problem is already there, so the code we have to work with is already too complex, then a complexity metric, or applying more complexity metrics, can tell us that which part of the code system is the most complicated one, which one we should refactor. And it tells when should we refactor, when it exceeds a certain limit of complexity. Okay, and the best thing if you are working not just by yourself, but if you have some colleagues as well who are always writing dirty code and it's very hard to understand, then you can blame them based on these complexity metrics that, hey, the complexity metric says that So you can blame your colleagues with this one.
Sorry.
Powerful guy. So if you want to blame the others that, hey, you shouldn't write this code because it makes the code very hard to maintain in the future. Okay, here is another conversation. If you ask your friend that, hey, could you approve my pull request, please? Then your partner will say that, oh no, this is such a dirty thing, I cannot approve this, sorry. Then your partner says that, no, it's not complex, it's quite simple, just try to understand it. And yes, it is messy. No, it is not messy. Yes, it is. No, it is not. So this conversation is an endless pain. And the solution for this debate is to define the complexity metrics. If the code exceeds that limit, then it shouldn't be committed to the common code base. Okay, how can we measure the code base? There are many tools. You can do it manually, which is the most problematic one. You can create some bash or whatever else scripts to measure some simple and easy metrics. For example, this one measures one file and counts how many lines the file has. It's a very simple one. If you want to measure more complex complexity metrics, it's a nice sentence, then such tools don't work really well. So in this case, some dedicated tool should be used. One of the dedicated tools related to PHP, which I worked a little bit, is called PHP metrics. This is what I would like to introduce you today. What does it do? First of all, it parses your files. By default, it parses the PHP files, but you can add some other extensions and exclude some other files. So for example, if you want to parse your .inc files as well, then you can, or if you want to include the vendor folder, the PHP files from the vendor folder, then you can make an exclusion list as well. But basically, it parses your files. And then, for each file, it calculates a lot of different metrics. And then it creates a report in many, many formats. There is one format for human. So for example, if you want to understand what the result of this analysis is, or you want to show your boss or your colleagues how nice your code is, and then the HTML report can be useful for this one. Otherwise, if you want to process the report by computer, then there are some options for this one as well, XML, JSON, CSV, blah, blah, blah. What kind of report you can get from the PHP metrics? This sample is one example. This chart shows that this project has so many files. Each little circle belongs to one file, and this file is called bank.php, and one of the complexity metrics, the cyclomatic complexity I will talk about later, it is 120. So the size of the circle shows how complex that file is. So if your project has some many, many approximately same size circle, then it's more or less okay. If you have a huge circle and many, many small ones, then the huge one has to be separated into smaller parts. So code refactoring should be done. Or there is another option. I used to work in a project, I think about a year ago, when I used this PHP metrics, and we had a huge, massive circle in the middle of the chart. And it turned out it was, I think, a 3,000 or 4,000 line long uglified PHP code, which was a standalone PHP file for some database manipulation thing. It was like PHP MyAdmin or something like this. So it was able to connect to a database, show table contents, and change the schema and so on. So it was quite a complex tool, but it was compressed into one huge file, and it covered, I think, 70% of the whole diagram, and a couple of thousands of other small circles were there. So in this case, it is a third-party software. I don't want to analyze it. I don't want to modernize it. I don't want to refactor it. It has to be excluded from the analysis. So in this this case, the exclusion list comes to rescue us. Okay, so this is a very useful chart. This is another chart. You can define the X and Y axis and the size of the circles. So for example, in this case, some complexity and another complexity called LCOM are represented on the X and the Y axis, and the circle size is the lines of code, LOC. So from this chart, you can see that, oh, the big circle here is not just complex in size of in the matter of lines of code, the LOC, but it is too complex in this direction and this direction as well. If something is a big circle, but it is here, it means that it may have a lot of lines, but otherwise it is not too complex. So such a chart can be also very handy, and so on. Another very useful diagram contains a lot of numbers. So if you want to impress your boss with numbers, if he likes them, then such a report can be helpful for them. Here is the file structure of the project. You can open and close them with the plus and minus symbols. And here are different numbers for different metrics. This PHP metrics is an open source project. I haven't said it, but it is. So you can download it, you can extend it, you can see how it works. For example, this column, the file size, it is my contribution to the software, which I'm very proud of. So the point is that if you want to add a more complex complexity metric, then you can. You just have to write the appropriate part of the code, and it is a modularized system, so it is easy to add to the code. Okay, what does it measure? I mean, the PHP metrics tool, what does it measure? A lot of things Here is a link which leads to the site where the different metrics of the previous table are listed. And here is one more link and one more, which leads to two Wikipedia pages. The middle one, the health state complexity measures, it is basically a huge bunch of different metrics based on four numbers. If you open the Wikipedia page, then it is described there in details. But the point is that the PHP metrics has to measure only these four numbers for a particular size, for a particular file. These numbers are how many symbols are there, how many different symbols are there. So if there is $A, then it is two from one point of view, but they are the same, so it is only one from the other point of view, and two more numbers. And from these four numbers, a lot of other complexity metrics are able to be generated. So the Halmai complexity measures is a huge bunch of metrics computed from these four numbers, and they are very interesting. For example, there is a measure which tells you how much time it requires for you, for an average developer, to understand that particular code, which seems to be very hard to estimate, but there is a formula with some complex, some constants describing an average developer, and it reports how much time it requires for an average developer to understand it. Okay, and the other complexity metric we frequently can meet is the cyclomatic complexity, which is a metric that basically describes how many paths are there from the beginning of the code to the end of the code. So for example, if there is no condition, no for loop, no nothing else in the code, just subsequent condition, subsequent comments after each other, then it's only one, because there is only one path. If there is an if statement, there are two possible ways how you can execute the code. So the cyclomatic complexity measure, this metric, this describes the complexity from such a point of view. The PHP metrics can list a lot of complexity metrics. Here are some of them. I didn't want it to list you one by one. The only reason why I put it here, just to show you how many of them there are. A lot. Okay. At one of my earlier workplaces, it also happened about one and a half years ago, I worked with an old legacy code where there were some very, very long files. The most disgusting one was about 4,000 lines long. And the problem was that it was not just long, it didn't have any structure. I mean, there was, I think, only one function, which was 5 lines long. Apart from those 5 lines, the whole script was just one mess of code with different depth of indentation. The deepest part was 18 level deep. You can imagine how complex it was. So at the time, I thought that it would be interesting to measure how many variables I should keep in my mind if I want to understand a certain part of the code. So this was the base of proposing a new complexity metric, which is the scope size. The scope size tells you how many variables you have to keep in mind, you as a developer, if you want to understand the code, how many variables you have to keep in mind at this part of the code, at this part, at this part. It can be measured not just for variables, but for functions as well, how many function names are available from a certain point of view, how many classes are there, so you can create a couple of metrics based on this schema. The easiest way is to measure this metric after each semicolon. So for example, here is a very simple PHP code. In the beginning, we have no variables. We are ignoring the globals at the moment. So in the first line, we create one variable. So at the end of this line, this complexity metric is one. In the next line, we create another variable, and the third one, so the value is three. In the print line, there is no other variable, so it is still three. And in the last line, we unset a variable, so it jumps back to two. In that code I mentioned before, the 4,000 line long, it was the first time in my life when I started to love unset. So if you have the long code and you can say that, okay, this is the 100th line of the code, and from this point on later on, this variable is not used anymore, so I can unset it here. It is such a nice thing if you clean your desk in the weekend or something like this. So this is a metric which can describe such kind of complexity of the code. You can measure the maximum of this value during the whole file. So if in the beginning there is only one or two variables, in the middle it jumps up to 100, and then you remove those variables, then in the middle it is still 100. So if you want to understand the code, then it still requires some effort from you. So the maximum of this value, it is also an interesting description of the complexity of this file. Or you can calculate an average for this, for every line. So if you have very, very few variables in the beginning, you have 100 somewhere in the middle, and then it goes back to zero, it's a little bit different than if the peak in the number of variables is only at the end of the file. Because in this case, most of the file is easy to understand, only the last part is difficult. Only the last part is complex. So that's the reason why the average is also useful. Okay. Yep?
Can I have one question?
Sure.
So you measure the used variable or not used variable, or measure them together. So not sometimes, you know, in one programming, some variable we no longer use, but it's still there. We forgot to remove that.
Okay, so for example, in the previous case, if I don't print the variables, I just assign them, but I don't do anything with them. This is what you are asking, yeah, right?
Yeah.
Okay, it doesn't matter, because if the variable has some value, then I still have to keep it in mind.
Right.
So I don't care if it is printed or used in any way in the future. If it is created, if the value is there,
yeah,
then it counts.
So I think if we left so many unused variables, we don't think that is a good program yet.
Totally agree.
So
A function opens a new scope. So within the function, the variables outside of the functions are not visible.
No. Well, I'm talking about two functions. They just in the same, not same scope, they different scope. But the
in the same file?
Not same file. I mean, let me think that we have two files.
Mm-hmm.
File contain one function, yeah?
This one is a file-based metric. Yep.
One file have five variables as well.
Yep.
But one file have only one variable have been used.
Yep.
Another four didn't use.
Okay.
So one file, they're using all five variables.
Yep.
Right? So, but I think that score is the same. Because they
yes, it will
all
be.
Have five variables.
Yes, yes.
So I think the first one is worse than the second one because they don't use all of the variables. But the second one, they're using them all.
Did you understand in the back what he said? Okay. So if you have a bunch of variables here,
yeah,
and you use them, and in the other file you have the same variables but you don't use them, from some point of view the complexity is still the same, because if you want to understand what this variable is, this was a string, it was a number, it was an object, whatever. Sorry? You have to keep it in mind, yeah. So even if you don't use it, it's even worse because it's just confusing.
Yeah.
Why was the variable created there and why is it not used here? Why is the trick?
And also that kind of thing would be picked up by a linter. You know, if you use a linting program, it would show you variable not used.
I know, but
or if you use PHP stolen by our sponsor.
I try to understand the concept. So the metric is help me to make the problem better or just give me your score.
So it's very important to see that complexity metric is a very complex mapping. So you have a huge source file which is mapped into one number. It cannot describe everything.
Yep. Help me to understand which part file is wrong code.
Yep.
Which part is good. But the metric just tell you, give you a score and tell you this 25%. I don't think this really helped me.
It's true. It's true. So in this case, the same complexity would suggest that they are complex the same way, to the same extent, but it is not true. This is okay. In this case, some more metrics can help you. So, for example, the Halstead metrics I mentioned before, based on those four constants, four parameters, they can describe more precisely what the difference is between them. Okay. So that's the reason why you should apply more complexity metrics in order to get a general impression of how complex the file is. Okay? Good.
Okay.
Done? Okay. Any questions? Okay. If not, then let's continue. Let's talk a couple of sentences about the future of PHP metrics. So I tried to check the newest version of PHP metrics last night. Sooner is better, but late is not too late. And I had serious problems. I tried it on Windows, I tried it on Linux, and the same problem was there. I installed it in the way how it was described. I started to analyze only one index.php, which had two lines, $x equals to one, and print x. So the code was very simple. It was unable to analyze it, and it just reported me a lot of array reference errors. I don't even know what it was. I was too tired to debug the code, but the point is that the current version you can download from GitHub, or I was able to download from GitHub, it didn't work. Fortunately, the code was forked a couple of months ago, and the legacy version is still there on the GitHub, so I downloaded that one, which was still wrong. But I used an even older version of the legacy version, which worked. So this was the way how I was able to create the screenshots for you. The point is that the code is really nice from inside. So if you start to understand how it works, then the code is nice, but it doesn't work properly. So in the future, it has to be regenerated or creating more robust. The next thing is that, as you mentioned, there can be some cases when the metrics you use, they don't describe precisely what complexity you are caring about. So in this case, you may have come with some other ideas. Oh, it would be very nice to measure the length of the longest line of the code, which also can be a metric. If you have such an idea, then you can edit. And after a couple of months, the maintainers of the code will merge your pull request. I had to wait for 6 months for my very simple change. So it's not a quickly reacting company, but they do it. Okay. The next one is that, as I mentioned earlier, this tool is able to generate HTML report for personal process, for human process, and other files, CSV, JSON, XML, for computer processing. So if you use a tool which integrates your code with your peer developers, then these files are very handy to analyze. PHP metrics has Jenkins support, so if you use some continuous integration tool like Jenkins, then after each commit or deployment, it can tell you how complex the code is at the moment. Related to this bullet point, I wanted to talk about some Git hooks. So for example, if you commit your newest code you created Friday afternoon and you want it to go to the pub, and it is much more complex than it should be, then you just quickly commit it, the repository sucks it, and the next week your colleagues suffer a lot because your code is too complex. So such a Git hook could stop you and not allowing to commit such a complex tool. But in order to this one, every time when a commit is created, the PHP metrics should be fired, and the result should be analyzed, And if the result shows that the code you wanted to commit is too complex, then the whole thing should be rejected. Okay. This thing is partly done. So for Jenkins, it works fine. But if you use some other tool, then you may have some problems. So it's also a lot of, it gives you a lot of area where you can contribute to the project. Okay, what are the conclusions from this? First of all, measuring the code complexity you write is absolutely necessary. It is not too difficult. Let's not talk about how complicated it is to install PHP metrics, but if it is installed there, then it's very handy to launch it, check the result, launch it, check the result. Unfortunately, it is not a very quick one, so it can take a couple of minutes while it passes your thousands of files. But it's not your work, it's just the computer's work. Okay? So every time when you create a commit, then it should be considered how complex your code is. And if it is too complex, then it shouldn't be allowed to add it to the repository. Thank you. Okay. Any questions?
Yes. Do you have any recurrent?
Sorry?
Is there any recurrent number of the results you recommend? Do you think it's better code of the code?
Yes, 42. So in general, I cannot tell you what is the maximum file length you should allow or something like this. It depends on the programming language. So in PHP, maybe some value is a good value. In an assembly source code, it can be totally wrong. In JavaScript, it can be also wrong, and so on. So it depends on the programming language. If you are talking about PHP, because PHP metrics analyzes just PHP programs, then it depends on your team. So if you work with a frequently changing team who has a lot of new members every time, then it requires much more time for them to understand the whole thing. So in this case, it's better to keep the values low. But if you have a couple of developers who are you working together with for, you have been working together with for 10 years, then this value can be much higher. So I cannot tell you an explicit number, but sorry?
I don't need a specific number. I really want to know how big size the project, mapping how much number. Like, for example, if I have 5 files, maybe I can get the number. If this project has about 100 files, what kind of number I'm looking for?
Mm-hmm. So the number of the files is not a metric PHP metrics can analyze, because PHP metrics works with individual files. So it doesn't care about the number of the whole files.
Okay.
You can use some other tool, even in Bash, to calculate how.
Maybe the line.
Yeah, the lines, you can compute it, yeah.
So for example, if I have a 1,000 line of the file,
yep.
So what kind of number I can get? What kind of number is good? Or if more than 10,000,
it's probably wrong. 10,000 is probably wrong.
So you probably add a metric to the stack if you wanted to. You make a contribution and add a metric that checks the density of the code and how,
yeah.
If it's really, really shallow and there's lots of files, maybe it's not complex enough. Maybe you've got too many files and it's going to be so much file hopping that you won't be able to find your way through the program.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. And then to check the project, the tile project composite. I mean, you said the PHP metric is only checking the individual file. But
it checks a subdirectory,
yeah.
All of the files in that subdirectory,
right.
Including the edit extensions and excluding the excluding list. But yes, it investigates a lot of files and reports the analysis of all of them.
Okay, but the report based on the single file, yeah?
Yes.
But you didn't add it to check the entire project?
No. PHP metrics doesn't do this. That doesn't do that.
But I mean, if any other tool can do this,
I am not aware of any, but there can be.
Did you happen to check the complexity of PHP metrics?
actually, it's a very good question, and the answer is that the PHP metrics itself has its own analysis on their website. So it's, I think I can show it. Doesn't matter. Is here a browser on this computer? How can I access from this? Is it a virtual machine or what?
Sorry?
Is it a virtual machine or what? Can I access from this easily?
No.
No. Okay,
so. Firefox. There's no internet anyway, so.
Okay. Okay, so the answer is that yes. Okay. So the chart, the bubble chart for PHP metrics is quite nice. I mean, it has some bigger circles and a lot of smaller ones, but it is not distorted to any direction, so it's good. You wanted to ask something.
What are the most important metrics?
There is no one. You cannot say that this one is more important than the other one. There are ones who which are used more frequently. For example, the lines of code is an important one. Cyclomatic complexity is also a frequently used one. Some of the health state metrics derivatives are also frequently used, but I wouldn't say that in your project you use only this one or that one, because one is not enough.
I mean the most important ones.
Okay. If we check this list, then this is in alphabetical order, so you can pick some if you want. I wouldn't say that some of them is more important than the other ones. the length in health state matter, so it's not the file size. It's coming from those four variables I mentioned. It is an important thing. The number of classes, it also can be interesting. In PHP world, you should have only one class in each file. The number of operators is an easy to understand metric. So it's very, very important if you are talking about metrics and it's too complex to imagine what it means, then it is not a good metric. So if you say that, oh, this core is too complex in threads metrics, because it is 50 instead of 40. 40 is the limit, and we have 50. And nobody knows what 40 means and what 50 means, then it's a wrong metric. I mean, it's a good metric, but not too usable. It's much better if the value of the metric tells you something. OK? Good. Any more questions? Yeah?
Is there any work being done to correlate combinations of metrics? So I don't know whether they're just running the code. Or is there metadata being gathered to say, okay, you start seeing this metric being high and that metric being high together? You know, people are commonly reporting that's a difficult to read code base.
Yeah.
Is it gathering information to start doing some of those complex correlation work?
I would say that basically or generally, there are some metrics that correlate. For example, the number of the lines and the file size that correlate, but you can create some artificial examples, which shows you that no, I can write one line code which is very complex or the opposite direction. So,
because it'd be great if you get to the point where there was enough detail in the algorithm to say, actually, it looks like you're trying to solve a really simple problem, but you've done it in a really complicated way,
mm-hmm.
or look, this looks like a really complicated problem, so probably this complexity is necessary to solve. If you can start getting to that level. I'm really curious.
I cannot really tell you.
The data would probably be in there, but you can get it out.
Yeah, so I can imagine that there are some tasks when you have to write a code which reaches a certain complexity. If this is the case and you cannot break it down into smaller parts and you cannot make it more.
Because the immediate thing to me, right, is have I done this the hard way or the easy way? And if I could have an algorithm that could tell me, yeah, you solved a simple problem the hard way, that would at least be nice to know.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm sure I have.
Yeah. So in this case, you have to make this limit a little bit higher. So you can say that, okay, I allow a file to be longer than 1,000 lines and 1,200 is allowed from now on. Or you can say that this file is the only exception. Now I allow, but apart from this file, we should keep the 1,000 line limit. They both can work. Okay. Anything else? Yeah?
You mentioned the commit hooks. So are you running PHP metrics locally and then send some data to?
I use it locally, but you can install it to the server. And if you install it to the server, then the server-side hook. It's not too quick, as I mentioned. So it requires quite a lot.
So it's quite fast?
No, not fast.
Not fast.
I'm saying that if you have thousands of files, then it can take a couple of minutes.
So it's better to install it locally?
It depends on, because if you create a commit and for 1 minute it's just waiting and waiting, then you won't like it. It's better to send it to the server, and the server will refuse if it is too complex. Normally, so in your everyday routine, it is not too complex. So you cross the threshold quite rarely. So it is your task to change the code if it is too complex, but your everyday routine will not exceed that limit. So that's the reason why I would keep it on the server. Okay, anything else?
So the metric will only tell you how complex the project is, but they don't tell you anything about how to improve it.
It's correct. Okay. It's correct. This file is too long. Make it smaller. I don't care how.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's all. Okay, thank you. Thanks.